Today in this video we will discuss about the calculation of national income through three methods. So first, in this video I'll discuss the income method of estimating national income of a country. So normally national income, we know that national income is the sum of income earned by the domestically owned factors of production within a particular time period. Normally, we consider it as 1 year, one financial year. Sometimes also we measure national income quarterly or on the monthly basis. So income method, if we do it in the income method, so this is a direct method of estimating national income. We directly calculate the national income of a country. So first here, we will differentiate between the different income earning units. So there are normally three types of units. We can make broad classification. One is the employees. So number two, employees means they only have their labor, physical or mental effort. So they don't have other factors of production. And second is the employers who own the other factors of production, but they only hire labor or workers. And third type of employee is self-employed. So what we do whenever calculating the or estimating the national income, we just find out all the, identify all the employees. Employers means they are the owner of other factors. That means employees have only labor and the employers have land, capital and organization. And whereas self-employed people, they are the owner of the land, capital, organization as well as they are the labor. So I'll give the example later. So these are the three things, and we identify all factors of production within the domestic boundary of a country. So here, in this case, so first we will come with the employees. So employees' income, they have two parts of their income. So we call it, whenever we are considering the income of the employee, we call it that compensation of employees. So in the compensation package, there are two components here. One component we call it wages and salaries. Normally wage is meant for the casual workers and salary is for the formal workers. And second thing is the employer's contribution to social security schemes. So what are the social security schemes? Just I'm giving one example that whenever one employee is employed in any organization, an amount of his salary is deducted as provident fund. So another part is contributed by the employer. So the provident fund of the employee that is contributed by the employer, that is called employer's contribution to the social security schemes. Similarly, if the employer pays the premium of the life insurance of the employees, that is also a part of the employer's compensation to the social security schemes. If the employer provides the medical insurance premium, that is also considered as the employer's contribution to social security schemes. So these are the compensation to employees. Now we will consider the other part, the employers. That means the employer's reward is known as, in general it is known as operating surplus. So number two component of national income, component B, is called operating surplus. That means the surplus in the hand of the employers after making payment to the employees. And operating surplus has its three components. A is rent for their own land, interest for the capital, and C is the profit for entrepreneurship or management or organization, whatever we say. So this is the part is called operating surplus. And beyond that, the third component is called mixed income of self-employed. So this example is a small businessman. He is the owner of the land, he is the owner of the capital, he is the owner of the organization, and he himself is the laborer in his. For example, we consider a small shopkeeper, a small businessman. So he works as the four factors. That's why his income is considered as mixed income. So if we add component A, B, and C. So A, compensation of employees. B, operating surplus. And C, the mixed income of the self-employed. But here we have to add one more component which we have not yet considered. Because we are considering compensation to employees, operating surplus, and mixed income inside the domestic boundary of the country. But remember that all the factors of the country are not operating inside the country. Point number one. And point number two is all the factors operating inside the country are not domestically owned. That means the foreign factors may constitute any part of this, may have a component in any part. So just for example, if we consider that Daimler is a British company. So whenever it is operating inside the market of US, so its operating surplus, that means the profit of the Daimler company, is not a part of US national income. So it should be excluded from here. Similarly, if we are considering that General Motors is operating, has a factory in the market of Great Britain or England. So whatever the earn, the profit is made by the General Motors company from the Britain market or the British market, that is not considered here. But it is the definitely owned by US entrepreneurship. So its income, its profit must be included into US national income. So that's why we have to use the fourth term here, what we call this is called as net factor income from abroad. So what we have to do, if we are considering the estimating the national income of USA, we have to add the factor income, the income of factors owned by US citizens outside US, and we have to subtract the income of foreign factors inside US market. So that is the concept of net factor income from abroad. Now if we do it A, B, C, and D, if we add these four components, we will get national income of a country of US. So national income is the sum of compensation of employees, operating surplus, mixed income, and net factor income from abroad. There are some precautions which are to be maintained, which are to be followed while calculating national income of any country. So precaution number one is that we should calculate only factor income. So factor income means what? The income which is earned by participating in any production process. So if we, any type of unilateral transfer should be excluded. So for example, if government is providing the allowance to the unemployed people of the country, that should be excluded from national income. If any, there is any type of transfer, unilateral transfer, that should be excluded from national income. Any type of gift, any type of financial aid, any type of pension to the freedom fighters, any type of, just there, any type of temporary assistance to needy families, all should be excluded. We will consider only the income which is earned by participating in the production of goods or services. So these things are to be maintained. Only factor income, number two, it should exclude any kind of unilateral transfers. So similarly, third thing is that any gain, windfall gain, should be avoided. Any type of windfall gain, that means earning money from lottery, that should be excluded because that is not generated through participating in production process. So any type of windfall gains that should be excluded. And also the capital gain in the share market, that should be excluded because capital gain in share market, that is done by simply by the fluctuations of demand and supply. If you consider you are purchasing share at low prices and selling that at the same share at high price, so this gain will not be considered as a part of national income because this increase in price simply due to the fluctuations in demand and supply. So the any capital gain in the share market should not be excluded. Now we can take practice one sum here. The estimation of national income. So I am giving some hypothetical values of any country in dollar million. So first, if we consider that wages and salaries 200. So component A, component B, employers contribution to $40. Rent 30. Interest 50. Profit 300. Mixed income 250 and net factor income from abroad is minus 20. So what will be the national income? So NI will be equal to compensation to employees A plus B. This is compensation to employees, plus C plus D plus E. This is the operating surplus, plus F, mixed income of self-employed, plus G. So 200 A plus B equals to 240, plus rent 30, interest 50, 80, plus 380, plus 250 minus 20. So national income will be 240 plus 380 620 plus 250 870 minus 20 equals to 850. So this is, if the data is given, this is how we'll calculate national income in income method. And we have to remember the precautions which should be followed while calculating national income in income method. So this is the income method. In our next part, we will discuss to estimate national income through expenditure method.